As I take your hand and lead you to the dance floor, as the music dies, something in your eyes calls to mind a silver screen of dark and sad goodbye.
I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend, I know you're not a fool. Should've known that I've had to cheat a friend. A wasted chance that I feel given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I dance with you.
The careless whispers of a good friend to the heart and mind. Ignorance is kind, but there's no comfort in the truth. The pain is the harder you find.
I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. Though it's easy to pretend, I know you're not.
Okay. You don't start what? Hello everyone. Hello everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, irrespective of where you are joining us from. And I'm saying a very big, big welcome to every one of us for our first, compliment of the season. Good to have every one of us and good to see everyone in 2022. And trust me, this year will definitely be great. Yes, 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 yes. So once again, welcome to Time Out with Victor on Financial Modeling Bootcamp. And the focus of this bootcamp is to run us through how do you build a model for a startup company, a company that has no historical data. One good thing about modeling is the concepts remains the same thing, right? The methodology remains the same thing as well. So how do you get to build a model for a company that has no historical data, nothing, and you just need to make a forecast for them? And that's what we'll be running ourselves through during this training. And the focus will be more of a tech company, right? The world is really moving fast and a lot of tech companies coming up to take over some of our old companies. So once again, I say my very big welcome to everyone of us. So I will appreciate if you can just type in the chat box as well, just to say hi and maybe where you are connecting from as well. Yes. So let me tap my own eye. I think I'm connecting from Nigeria. Okay. All right. So just type I in the chat box. All right. Let's know where we are connecting from. Good to have every one of us as well. So yes, this is my face. I hope I'm looking like the same way I appear in the picture. Okay, so we have some of us from Sierra Leone. Good. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. All right, so without wasting much of our time, let's get straight into what we'll be doing today. Okay, yes, we have some of our colleagues from Arab Emirates, Bangladesh, right? So good to have every one of us. Thank you so much. Thank you for joining this bootcamp. Now, just to remind us that this is more like the session one, and we decided to make it open to everyone, right? The fact that you're able to attend the first session does not guarantee you'll be able to attend the second session. But trust me, I'm quite sure this first session will be enough to convince you of what this bootcamp program we old. Trust me, I've done a lot of courses when it comes to financial modeling. And what we'll be training ourselves on this boot camp, trust me, it's not something you'll be able to get on some of these online courses. If you want to learn anything, it's always good to learn from people that that are doing it day by day as part of their own job role, right? So that's what we'll be doing today. So bootcamp, the agenda of this bootcamp is number one, I know that many people like know how to build a model, but not everyone can build a model that kind of go in line with the standard. So as a financial modeler, we have something we call FAST standard, F-A-S-T. It's actually an acronym. The same way you're building your model should be flexible, accurate, well-structured, and also transparent. So, and it always starts from how do you get to build a good model template? And that's what we'll be doing today as well. Then how do you get assumption building a model? People usually they get stuck and like, how do I just get data? This company has no historical data, nothing on them, and they still want to build a model for them. How do you approach that? So we try to forecast the three financial statements. We go ahead and try to evaluate the business itself, right? Every model you build must have one or two objective as to why you are building the model. And from most tech company, most time their metrics really speak more than the actually discounted cash flow. Yeah, so you're talking to investors, they're asking you some questions. What is your business? What will be your business churn rate? What will be your customer lifetime value of the business, right? What will be the average revenue per users? So what will be your burn rate? All those kind of metrics, those are what they use in evaluating the investments committed into the business. Then we're going to have a concept, we discuss concept of business valuation, and my partner will be coming in to run us through some concept on valuation. And also, during this our process of building the model, it's very practical. A real case study. We've been making use of some Microsoft Excel, right? So trust me on that. Then it will go alongside with advanced data presentation skill. How do you get to present? How do you get to structure your model such a way that they can pick it and they can understand everything you've done? So let's appreciate our sponsor and our people that are supporting this bootcamp. The first one is Dbrand Consulting. Yes, I currently work with Dbrand Consulting as a financial model analyst and also a corporate trainer. Yes, so I train corporate institution on financial modeling, most corporate finance modeling, and also Microsoft, and alongside with our Microsoft most valuable professional community. Yes, I'm also a Microsoft MVP. So they are supporting us on this. And also Adedolamu Shogilola works with Deloitte Nigeria, and is a financial analyst and also valuation and modeling analyst too. He will be the one to run us through the parts of the business valuation. So if, in case you still want to support us, maybe you will just want to share some of your knowledge with us as well, you can always reach out to me as well. So maybe we just create a session for you so that you can also share any part of your knowledge. Remember, this bootcamp is 100% free. Yes, it's 100% free as well. So we are not collecting any money from anyone, and we'll be training us fully on this part as well. All right, so building a professional model template interface, and that will be the first thing we'll be doing today. So we'll be more focused on the practical aspect of it. Any material we need, maybe you need to read up on something, can always share that with us. The live session will be more focused on the practical aspect of it, right? So let's get straight into what we'll be doing today. Yes. So let me go straight to my blank Excel. Right, and let's kickstart the session now. Just to give us a clue, we have over 245 people that really applied for this. Luckily, I think our Zoom can only take up to 100, max of 100, and we've reached that max now. So this is what we are going to do. We wanted to run a test in order to select people, but we have to think the other way around. right? I can, the truth is, most time, yes, you might do a test and fail. It does not mean you don't know it, right? At times you might not be in a good shape whenever you are having a test, so, and that should not restrict us. So what we are going to do is, everything we are going to do today, I would like us to focus on it, right? Ask as much question as possible. I will share the video with us immediately we are through with the session. Then you need to use the video to create your own template and forward your template to us. So only people that are able to get that done before Sunday that will be admitted into our bootcamp program. So that is more like you trying to show your level of commitment. And that's the whole thing about this, right? Show your commitment. Let this bootcamp impact you in one or two ways, right? As I said, irrespective, I've done a lot of courses. Some things we'll be doing, they are not what you can get online or any courses. So please, our commitment is all we need. Yes, yes. Nobody's collecting money for this bootcamp. So, all right. So let me stop sharing my video so that I'll be able to concentrate on what we'll be doing. So the first thing is for us to try and convert a blank Excel worksheet. So yes. So someone is asking a question. Speaking of the template, is it the exact replica of what we taught today? Exactly. Yes, yes. We're going to build it together. Just focus. I will share the video with us so that you can use it to build your own and then share it with us later. Right. Okay. So whenever you want to build a model, remember the first thing is I'm actually not a template and a model analyst. Yeah, I don't like working on people's templates. I usually prefer to start from scratch. Yes, blank Excel. Even if you are writing the financial modeling exam, which is being conducted by Financial Modeling Institute, they will give you a real business case, ask you to build from a blank worksheet. So it's always good you know how to do that. So now, okay, let me create a blank a new Excel worksheet. Yes, the video will be shared after the meeting, definitely, so that you can use it to build your own and then share it with us. Yes, just focus. If you have any question, but in case I do any magic, just ask. Yes. All right, so I'll start with a blank Excel. Let me reduce this. So one thing I like doing whenever I'm working on Excel, is I don't like this grid line. You can see all this, you can see this line, right? This line, this ash color line. So I can remove it. So you have shortcut that you can use, and you also have another one that you can use. So you go to your view tab. So under this, your view tab. So under each tab, you always have something we call sub tab. So under view tab, you can see this guy called show. You can see this guy called show. And if you look closely, you see one guy called grid line. You see headings, and you also see this guy called formula bar. You can see currently my one is ticked. So if I untick this grid line, look at what happened. All the grid line will disappear. It'll look more like a plain paper. If I tick it, look at what happened. If I untick my headings, look at what happened. All those A, B, C, and 1, 2, 3, the rows and columns will disappear. If I tick it, it will appear again. This formula bar, you see that we have this our formula bar here. You can see this. If I untick this formula bar, look at what happened. The formula bar will also disappear. So maybe you've seen one Excel file where you see that the rows and the alphabets are not showing. This is what they've done. So we untick the grid line so that I can have a blank, just like normal A4 paper. I really prefer it like this. Then here, I will come to this, my name, which we have, where we have this sheet one. So you can see sheet one, where we have this sheet one. So I will double click on it and let me call this my cover. So let me call this my cover. So your model should always read like a book. So whenever you are building your model, just set your mind as if you are creating a book, right? When you build your model, it must be printable. People should be able to print it. So let's start. So let me go to my inserts. I need a shape. So let me select this rounded corner rectangular shape. So let me put it here. So I don't need this fill color. So in Excel, There are some things in Excel. If it is not in a cell in Excel, it's actually not an Excel. So, and those kind of things usually come with their own special tab. For example, most of the things you have under Insert tab, they are really not Excel, which means they usually come with their own tab. Now, look at me now. Look at my tab currently. When I click on any of the cell, look at my last tab. My last tab here is Victor. You guys don't mind me. I created my own personal tab, then I put my name. Now, if I click on this shape, look at what happened. You see that it comes with its own special tab. So which means if I want to do some other thing with this shape, I can go to this shape format and I can do whatever thing I want to do there. If I click outside it again, you see that that tab will disappear, right? So that's why we said they are more like adding into Excel. All right, so shape fill, I will just click on no fill. I'll click on no fill. I'll just click on the no fill. Okay, someone is trying to show their video. We can see your face. We can see your face, Michael Assis. We can see your video. We can see your video. No worry, maybe we share a video later, right? But for now, we can just off it, switch that off. So here I have it, and let me change the outline color. Let me change the outline color. I think I'll prefer something like ash as well, so it kind of look like this, right? So we have this, I've created this. So let me put this as our title. So for example, let me just write something. Let me say this is our bootcamp. Okay, let's create the layout first. I think that will be better. So just for us to also keep in mind, you can be creative with your model templates. Just make sure it is well structured. Make sure it is well structured, right? So let me call this so we are going to have our company name here. Company name, let's say our business operations. Okay, no, let's say our business industry. So we're going to have the business industry here. We're going to have our business industry, right? Then let's call this our business location. So we have our business location. So let me play with this a little bit. Let me make it bigger. That's, I think, 36. And I can change the color to maybe blue. Okay, blue, then the business location. Let me increase it and let me put it in just one. Just me just trying to, you know, now just play. Right? Then I can make this a little bit of ash. All right. Okay, so we have this. So here, let me say my the model objective. Let's put the model objective here. So maybe to raise funding. Let's put that one there as well. So I can also make the color a little bit of blue, right? Okay, then so we're just trying to create the cover, just the cover page. You can be creative as any way you want it. So here, one thing I also like doing is to have my table of content on my cover page, table of content, so it's easy for them to navigate. So here, what are the, so let me try and reduce this I'll reduce this column B. Then this column C, I will also reduce it a little bit. So this guy is moving the same way I'm moving my cell and I don't want it to move. So what can I do? Immediately I click on that tab on my keyboard, I'll just press my Control 1. So to give me some format shape option here, I'll go to the last one, which is size and properties. And I'll click on this property part and click don't move or size with cell. Then I can close that. So even if I'm moving all my columns like this, to just stay the way it is. So it will not move alongside with that shape. Okay. So my table of contents, we need our input here. So let me call this input and calculations. So you, most times when you build your model, can only fall into under two category, right? Okay, let me try and reduce this so that I can zoom out very well. So input and calculation, and the second thing we need is our output and analysis. Just that two segments. Okay, so let me save it on my, so whenever you are building your model, it's always good to always save your model. So let me just save it on my desktop for now. So let's call this our bootcamp template. For most time, I usually set my own Excel to save everyone one, I think everyone wants minutes also. Yes. So here, what are the things that we need under our inputs? Definitely, we are going to have our inputs. Okay, let's call this, we're going to have our assumptions, right? So let me create some rows here. So shortcut to create rows, right? Where I'm still on this, my row 13, shift and space, then on my keyboard, I'll press my Control Shift plus and to automatically add those additional rows for me. So here, assumptions, then we're going to have our calculation. So let me call this our monthly calculations. So we are going to build everything out month on month, right? So monthly calculations. Then we are going to have some scenarios worksheet as well. So let's have that. Then for our outputs, we're going to have our monthly model, right? Then we're going to have our profits, our loss account. Then we're going to have our balance sheet, right? Then let me create another one here. So let me adjust this guy. Balance sheet, what other things do we need? We're going to have our cash flow statement. Then we are going to have our analysis, right? And then maybe by the time our colleague runs us through valuation, we can then apply that. So let me even call it DCF, DCF valuation. So let me call it analysis and metrics. Okay, so let's call it analysis, ratios, and our metrics. So we have this like this, right? So what I'm just trying to do is to just create this, our cover page. In fact, one thing I usually like doing is to also give a description of the business model. Yes, so let me just create some space here. So I'm going to insert a shape, then the text. So you have a text box. I'm going to put that text box in here. So for the text box, it comes with its own shape. Remember that. I'm going to keep shape fill, no fill. Shape outline, I don't need any outline for that. So let me just put some general description, right? Let me say bootcamp. Okay. Let me increase this font. So bootcamp limited, right, is a fintech business model. Let's say that we'll be lending funds to small business and individual and charge interest on the loan being given. So you're just giving that overview of what the business is all about. So that's from the cover page. It's easy for someone to understand what we have in the model. So I think it's looking good now. It's looking good. Right? I think it's looking nice like this. So this one, let me try and put it in the same. Okay, so let me make it a little bit bigger so that they have the same. All right. So I think this is looking good, small. As I said, someone said I'm too fast. Yes, don't worry. I'm going to share the video with us so that you can use that to kind of build your own. Yes. Don't worry. I'm going to share that with us. Yes, your own is just take a look at it. Let's try and understand what we are doing first. Then I will share the video with us so that you can use that to build your own. So you can just can be creative, just anyhow you want it, right? So these are our cover page. Now, one thing I also like doing is whenever I'm building a model for a company that has a logo, I usually like having their logo on background of my model. Right, so let me show us that. Let me try and download one company logo. I'm not going to share the worksheets. I will only share the video. Then you need to use the video to do what? To you use the video to create your own. Yes, to create your own, right? Let's just take a look at this together so that you understand what we are trying to do. So let's look for one company logo. In fact, let's use Microsoft. Let's look for Microsoft's logo. Yes, I think we can still use make use of their logo. So I'll just come here. Let me just copy any of their logo. So copy image. So I'm going to copy the image. I'm going to copy the image. I'll come to my Excel and I'll just paste it, Control V, right? So let me make it bigger. So what I want to do now is, what I want to achieve with this is, so said I'm too fast. Okay, I will try and slow down, right? Also remember, you will be sharing the video with us so that you can always watch it over and over again. Yes. Sorry about that. All right, so what we want to achieve now is this. We want to make this Microsoft logo, we want to have it as a background on our Excel. And how do I get to do that? I'll click on this, my Microsoft Excel. So now, if I'm clicking in any cell, see my last tab here is Victor. If I click on this Microsoft picture, look at what happened. It comes with its own tab, right? And what I want to do now is this. I want to reduce the appearance of this Microsoft, our logo. So to do that, while I'm still on this picture, I can just press my Control 1 to bring out the format picture. And I will click, so you have your bucket, you have fill and line, you also have effects, you have size and properties, then you have this picture. I'm going to click on this picture, and I will click on my picture transparency. Right, so my picture transparency, as you can see here, I'll click on my picture transparency, and I will increase it to, let's say, around 96. I think 96 is fine. Right, then I can close it, come back to this, my logo. Now, what I want is this. So, okay, someone is saying my Excel don't have picture transparency. That's not possible. It's supposed to. Yes. So maybe in case you are using the some Excel, different Excel version, they might give it different name. Yes. So check your format option. Okay. So now with this, let me even make it a little bit bigger. I can now right click. So right click and you see save as picture. So I'll click on the save as picture. Right. Let me just save it on my desktop for now. So I'm actually using Office 365. Yes. So let me call this logo background. And let me click on save. Now, I want to use this as a background. So to get that done, I will need to go to my page layout. So you have your home tab, insert, you have your page layout. So it is under this page layout that you will need to use that. So you see your page layout, right? You have your page setup. So you have margins, orientation, size, print area, breaks, background. So I need the background. So I'll just click on this background. So immediately I click on the background, it's going to ask me to insert a picture. And I'll click from a file. So I will navigate to where I've saved that picture on my system. I think that should be under my desktop. And I'll click on it and click insert. And look at what I have. Right, so you can see the logo of Microsoft as a background in my Excel. And I can always type anything on it and you can see that it is what? It is working. Right, so that's, I usually like doing this whenever I'm building a model for a client. Now, one other thing we also need to do is we need to set it to a printable format. So my Excel now, whenever you are building your model, it's always good to always set your Excel to a printable format, right? So to do that, right? Because if I press my Control P, look at what happened. See what has happened. This is not looking good. This is not how I want it. So I need to set this to a printable format. Also, you can see now that I have some funny page break line. I don't need that. So to remove that, I'll go to my file, right? Go to my options. I want to remove that. I want to remove this line. So I'll go to my, I go to other advanced, right? I think it should be under advanced. Then where is that? So let me see, under where do we have that? So you see under display option for this workbook, you see show page break. So I will untick it and click on my okay. And look at what happened. Those lines will disappear. Now to set this to a printable format, you'll be doing that on your page layout tab. Now, at times there are some things you might want to do and you will not see the options in the tab that you have. That does not mean it is not possible. So yeah, for someone that was saying does not have that picture format as well, maybe this could help. So if you look closely, let me circle that, please. You will see this option, this arrow that is pointing down. Look at this arrow. I just circle it. Let me circle it again. Look at this arrow that is pointing down. You have it here under the tab of scale, the sub tab of scale to fit. You see that you also have that option here. Under sheet option, you see that you also have that icon pointing down, so if you over your mouse on it, it will tell you. Don't see what you are looking for. Check out the full set of page formatting options. Right? Okay, someone is asking, don't they page breaks lay line help to know if your document has parts that are out of printable? So yes, if you want to work with it, fine, right? But most times, if you set your Excel to page, if you set it to a printable format, you might not need that. So it automatically adjusts itself. And that's what we want to try and do now. So this arrow that is pointing down, I'll just click on it. And it will bring out these options. Now, you have like four tab options here. Page, margins, head footer, and sheets. So we need almost all of them. So for the first one, landscape. Always by default, your Excel is set to portraits, but landscape is always good. So I'm going to click on the landscape. The scaling is automatically set to adjust to 100%. We don't need that. We need it to fit. So I'm going to tick on the fit to. This one, I will delete the one. And the wide bar, I'll just delete that one as well so that it automatically set itself. I'll go to the margins. I think this is fine. You can leave it the way it is. Headers and footer. So maybe by the time they are printing it, you want maybe some things to show below it. So let's show example. So you can customize header, customize footer. So I'm going to click on the custom footer. Now by my left corner, whenever they print this out, I want it to show printed on. So here you can see different options. Right, alphabets, you can see page numbers, calendar, timing, worksheet. So here, printed on, I will select the date and I type at, then select the time. At the center of the section, I want it to just show the sheet name. Then by my right, I want to have my page number. So insert page number, I'll click on the page of then the pages. And I'll click on my OK. Don't worry, I'm still going to do it again for us to see by the time we are creating the next worksheet. And I'll click on my OK. Now, if I print this, my Control P, look at what we have. So if you look down here, so I think my Excel is, I set my Excel to zoom to this part. So let me try and reduce that. All right, so most of the time I usually do that so that you can see my formula bar and make my formula big. Yeah, but that's fine, so that we can see that. So just to show that example of what we have, so you can see printed on 06 at 4:33 p.m. the worksheet name and page 2 of that page. So you have it like that. Right, so now this is cover page. We don't need all this space. So what I can do is I will highlight from this my column I. Right, I will highlight more like all the columns. So to do that, I'll just press my Control Shift, then my right arrow. It will take me to the last row, my last column in my Excel, and I'll press my Control Zero. So which means it's going to hide all those other worksheets. Then down here, I'll do the same thing. Let me highlight from my row 25, control shift down arrow, and press my control 9 this time to hide it. And you can see this. So let me also hide this alphabet of a thing. So let me hide my headers. And you can see this is what we call our cover page. This is what our cover page will look like. So by the time we have our company name, business industry, business location, we'll just link that to this cover page. And for this, we're also going to set the hyperlink for easy navigation. That's one, cover page. The second thing is to always have what we call guide. Our standard is saying whenever you are building a model, you should be able to build a model such a way that if you send it to someone in another country, they can pick the model and understand almost everything that you have done. So which means your model must have a guide that give a description to every value that you have in your model. And that's what we are going to use this worksheet to do. So I'm going to call this guide. So let me call this guy. Let me call it guide. First thing, I want to create that background. Let me remove this grid line. To remove that, you can use a shortcut, WVG. So to remove the grid line automatically, I'll go to my page layout. On this background, click on it. So I'll click from my file. I will navigate to where I have that logo and click on insert. So we have that logo, Microsoft logo as a background. I need to set this to printable format as well. Remember, click on this drop down arrow, change it to landscape, then fit to. I will remove this. I will delete this two. Margins, that one is fine. My headers, custom footer. So most time when I want to build a model, I will just create one Excel sheet and I will now replicate it so that I don't need to go through all this process again. Yes. So let me call printed on, select the calendar, then add, put the time to the middle one, center. I just need my sheet name. To the right, I need page of what of the pages. And I'll click on my OK. So the one for sheets, we did not touch that the other time. So by the time they are printing it out, maybe you have your year as headers. And you want it irrespective of the page they are printing, you want that year to be showing, right? That is what this will help us to do. So you can see rows to repeat at the top. So I will click on it and then I will highlight, let's just highlight from our row one to let's say row six. So irrespective of the page they are printing, anything we have from row one to six will be constant on all of the pages, right? And I'll click on my okay. So we have this. So this grid line, I don't need it, right? Go to my file, click on my options, then advance, and I'll scroll down to see. So display option for this workbook, and I will untick show page breaks, and I'll click on my okay. Right? So to make things so that I can work faster, let me just replicate this. So to replicate this, I will come to this guide, hold my control button, my left mouse, right? One icon will show as if it's one small cross sign. And I will just move it up to create another worksheet. So let me just call this sample. Then let's build our guide worksheet out. Let's build our worksheet guide out. So first thing, I like to collapse this first three. So I will highlight from my A to C, then just reduce those three columns. So the first thing that we need to have here, which is very important, is something we call model style guide. As I said, the standard is saying all the values in your model must have a clean and clear description. Okay, someone is asking, why did I select row one to six? For the tab, right? I said rows to repeat. So which means anything we have from row one to six. So maybe we have our name of company, the name of the worksheets, and then maybe the years and period. So that means whenever they are printing that, our Excel worksheet out. Those periods, everything we have from row 1 to 6, we be constant on all the worksheets. Yes, that's what help us to achieve. Right. So I'm still going to show us an example of it, of the output. All right. So model cell style guide. Now, many of us, when we build model, we spend a lot of time on it. In fact, model aside, even Excel as a whole. Excel is about efficiency and how it can help us to get what we do as fast as possible. That's the whole objective of Excel. Anything you want to do in Excel and it's taking you like 3 minutes to do, know that it is not efficient. And one of it is what we call this model cell style guide. Many people don't use it. Now let's assume I'm working in this, my worksheet. So let me go for a blank set. I need to type 5 here. But every time I type 5, I actually want this as a percent, right? So which means I will need to type 5, put my percent, enter. Now, anytime I type anything in percent, I will always like it to be in maybe, let's say, one particular color. Let's say this in 5, right? And if I type something like 100, I always want it to be maybe to give me something like 0.1, right? But every time I type this, I need to be working here and be adjusting it to fit into what I want. So if I type, maybe I'm looking for headings, let me call this that our model cell style. So anytime I type this, I want it to be maybe my style, is it correct? My cell style. So I always want it to be in bold and also underline. So which means if I go to another one and I'm creating another heading, right? So just, let me just type something here. I will need to still go back here and do this. Right, this is not efficient enough. What you can do is this: you can create some styles. So whenever you need that kind of styles, all you just need to do is to apply it. Now let me delete this. It's not what we need. I'm just using this as an example, and that is what we call this cell style that we have here. So you can see this cell style that we have here. Can see this cell style. Can see this cell style. Can see this cell style. We call it cell style. And if you click on this cell style, you will see that we have some pre-created cell style format here. Now look at what it does. Now here are my model cell style. Let me just highlight from this. Let me highlight all this row. And I come to this my cell style. You see this heading one. If I click on this heading one, look at what happened. It automatically do what? Format it into that cell style that has been created. If I click on, let's say, edit, let me click on this warning. Look at what happened. It turns it to red automatically, which means these are pre-formatted cell styles. So almost everything that you do under your font and alignment and number, these three options that you have under our home tab, you can actually pre-create them under your cell style. So now let's assume the way we want our headings to be. Let me delete this. Let me remove the format here. Yeah? That anytime we have maybe just heading parts, we want it to always be underlined. So let me say the underline should be in blue color. Let me say the underline should be in blue color. Right, it should be in blue color so you can see this, and I want the font to also be in blue color as well, right? So which means anytime I'm creating headings, I always want you to follow this format. But I don't want to be going through this process every time and be doing this over again, so which means I can create a cell style. So I'll come to this my cell styles. They've created some names, so you can also create your own, but you can still modify the one that they've created already. So here you can see heading one. If I right click on it, it will give me some options. Apply, modify, duplicate, delete. So let me modify. So if I click on my modify, you'll see that almost all the options that you have under our front alignment and number is what you can see here. You see your number, alignment, front, border, fuel, and protection. Right? And you can see this format. So I will click on this, my format options. What are the things that I need? You can see your alignment, your font. Number one, I need my font. I want the, so you can, you select the font. Calibri is fine. The color, you select the color you want. You select the size. I think 14 should be okay. Your border, we need a border. So this border is too thick. I can change the line. Click it here to change that. Right? What other things do we need? Do we need? So I think that's the only thing we need. Then I can click on my OK. And I can click on my OK. So if I highlight this cell style now, and I go to my cell style and click on this heading one, look at what happened. It automatically what? It automatically apply to the model. Do we understand that? So let me increase the font again. So right click, click on modify format. Right, so let me increase this one to 16 and click on my OK and click on my OK. So whenever I need something for this heading one, all I need to go, instead of going through this process again, I'll just come here, click on it and apply. Then I move on. So let me give a description here. Just to give explanation, this section highlights the this section kind of format painter. Yes, format painter is fine as well. Yes, we prefer to use format painter, right? So this section gives description. Description to value in the model. So let me try and reduce this, right? Then let me put it, I need it to be in explanatory format. So I will right click, let me modify this format. So I think 10 is fine. Let me click on OK. I think that's the only thing I need. So whenever I need that, I'll just go to my cell style, click explanatory notes. So just give me in this format. So what are these common cell style that we use in our model? The first one is we need our input cell style. Right? So yes, I set my Excel to a bigger size. So your own might not be looking like this. So it's because of presentation. So most times we usually set our Excel so that you'll be able to see it very well. So input cell style, right? We need our formula cells. So some cell that will contain formula. Which other one do we need? Then we might be linking some cells from another worksheet, right? Some cells to give us units. And then we might be needing our subtotal format, subtotal cells. Then we need our total cells as well. Then we're going to have our headings. So let's call it heading one. Then we're still going to have heading two as well. Right? So let me see if I can just remove this so that it's kind of looking way too big for me. Let's put it as my normal level. Okay. So let me save first, let me save, then let me open it again. Okay, please can you show how you create a cell style for those that don't? Okay, so in case you don't want to use the existing one, right? So let me, I think I should set it back to go to level. Okay. So in case you want to create your own cell style, yes, we are going to do that. We are going to create our cell style together. Yes. So for this one, let me just reduce everything here back to 11 so that I can zoom out very well. Okay. Okay. So here, let's create a sample. So let me type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So which means anytime I type a value like this, I want it to follow a particular format. Go to my cell styles. Yes, I have one cell called input cell style, but I want to create my own. How do you create it? So you can see this new cell style. I'll just click on new cell style. And I'll put my name, put the name. Let me call it input 2. What are the things that we need? Number format. So you need to tick and untick those ones you need and you don't need. For example, I don't need protection. we might need fill, we might need border, we might need font, we don't need alignment. Then this number, let's just format it. Start with the number. I just want it to be, we need only one decimal, right? And I think this will be fine. So anything that is in negative should be in brackets and red. We don't need alignment. Go to your front. For the front, anything that is in input, we want to use our blue color. Let's use the blue color for that. Let's look for more colors. I think there's a blue that is okay. So I think this blue is fine. Border, we want it to have a border. So maybe it's just ash border around it. Let me just select the ash color, then click the outline. Fill, we just want it to have a light blue fill. And I'll click on my OK. Right, so which means I've created a cell star and I'll click on OK. So if I need to apply it on this, all I need to go to my cell star and click on this input and look at what we have. So it automatically convert that. So let me type for the formula bar, 2345, enter. Now, by default, it is always set to your normal. So if you click on your cell star, you see your normal. Now, I don't like the way my normal is showing. I want my normal to be able to show in this 1000 format. So I can right click on this, my normal, modify it from there. Click on format, go to the number, custom. So under custom, you see different formats. So I think let's use this. And we need to just only one decimal. So as I said, this is more like advanced and these are basic Excel things. So maybe some other maybe one of these days we might have our bootcamp on Excel, only Excel. Yes. So these are more like basic Excel. Remember, we are not teaching Excel. Yes, yes. So I'll click on my OK. So whenever I type anything, it will come in this format. For the link cell style, so our standard is saying any input style should be in blue, right? Link should be in red. So I can go to my cell style. Let me create another one. So anyone you create, we always come up here under your custom. So new cell style, and I'll click on linked. Click on formats. I think we only need border. So, okay, font. We need our font to be red. So I can just select my red color, right? The font should be in 11. Okay, let's still leave that to the way it is because I've set my Excel to be bigger. Yes. So border, let's assume we also need let's have a red border around it, right? The number, so let me click on OK. So we really don't need the number. Can I tick the number? We only need the font and border. We don't need fill. We don't need this protection. I'll click on OK. So if I click on my cell star and I click on this link, you see what I have there. So units, so let me put this. Let's even say we have a currency here. Right, so we have a currency here. I want to put it in our explanatory format. So let me modify, let me increase it. Let me increase the font. Let me just put it 24 as well so that we have everything balanced. Right, so subtotal. So any cell that contain our total, what shape do we want? So you can see we have a total format here, but I need a subtotal. So I can right click and duplicate this to modify it. So I'll click on duplicate, call it total 2 format. Just want the border, only the border to be 1. So I don't need this one here. So I'll just leave the 1 up here and click on my OK. So whenever we select our subtotal, our total 2, so you see now, if I click on this total to look at what happened, it's changing my format of general and I don't want it to change that format. So go back, right click, modify, and I will untick this number. Only want it to change the font and the word and the border and give me the border. Click OK. So if I select it again, see now that it keeps it in this format. So total cell 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cell stars, you can just leave that in the total that they have already. So for the heading 1, let me type title 2 here, right? Go to my format cell star, heading 1. Let me modify that so that I can increase the font. So these are more like basic Excel of a thing. Yes, yes. So there are a lot of things most of us still need to learn when it comes to Excel. So these are more like basic Excel things. So for the heading 2, let me call this our title 2, right? And I'll create sales type, let me modify the heading to right click, modify. Then let me format that. Let me increase the font and change this. Let's use this as red, maybe. Then the border, I think we can also use red. As I said, you can be creative with your own. I'm still going, I will share the video with us. Also remember that. Click on my OK and OK. So if I apply this here, so with this now, it's as good as if you've given a description to the data in your module. In fact, most time I usually add some notes and comments to it, right? I usually add some comments here. So I put this hardcoded. I'll put hardcoded values. So let me create, let me reduce this column, then put it here. So let me put the comment here. So you can add just comment you're trying to give a description, right? So hardcoded value that can be changed. So just you put in that formula. So results of a calculations or functions. So you put that link. So data gotten from another worksheet or cell. So it's just you just trying to give description, right? So this one for the unit, so explanatory. So you can just be creative around that. So I'm going to leave that for us so that we can get to do that, right? So we've created our model cell style. What other things do we need to create? What other thing do you think we need to create to guide our users? Any other thing? Let me hear from us. What else do you think we need in our model cell style? So you can have as many cell styles that you want. Yes, you can list them out. Just immediately they are opening the cover page, they go to the guide and they understand that, okay, this is what you have in the model, and it's easy for them to navigate through your model without them having to call you to come and explain the model. So yeah, let me call this. So let me just copy this style. Let me put it. Okay, all right. So sorry, I was logged out. Yes, I think I'm back now. I'm back. Okay. I trust you can hear me now. Okay, all right. Okay. So here, let me just create this part. We are going to call this our model glossary. Right? Our model glossary and audit. So this place, in case maybe you use some abbreviation in the model and you don't want them to be calling you and be asking you, what is this? We can just put those, we can put them here. So let me call this explanation and model audit. So we are going to have that here. For example, we have anything we call P and L. So for example, if you look at your cover page, okay, is there anything? So P and L, what does that mean? So that means is what? It's profit or loss account. Okay, so someone is asking percentage sales style. Yes, as I said, you are going to create your own, and I want you to also be creative. So you can have as many percent as you want. We are trying to work with time, so that's why I'm just giving us this as a clue. So by the time you see this template we'll be working with, you already have that understanding. So you can have percent sales style, multiple sales style, table sales style, and as many cells that you can have in your model, you can have that here, right? So let me bring this down. Let me bring this down a little bit. So we need a section called our model information. So let me call this our model information. So let's call this our model information. So this is more like the details. The details of the business model. Okay. So here, first thing is we need our company name. Company name. So for now, let's just call it our bootcamp. Bootcamp. Our bootcamp limited. Right? Business. Business industry. So we're saying we are working with fintech. Right? So what's our location? Our business location. For now, let's work with Nigeria. Right? Yeah, I'm from Nigeria. So let's work with Nigeria. What other things can we have? So what is our model currency? So for my country, I think our model currency is Naira. So I have this. So let's have our model timing. Our model period starts. Our model period starts. So let me just put 01, 01, 20. Okay, let's just put 2022. So let me format this to, so dates are numbers in Excel. So to format this, I'll just need to press my Control Shift 3 and it will return it back to a normal date. Remember, now we are working with our what? Our model sales tag. So, and these are more like hard-coded values. So automatically, I need to put it, I need to abide by that guy that I've created myself. You can see that. So anything you see here, they understand that. Okay, so let me align everything to my, I think to my left, right? Yes, let's align everything to my left. So start period, put this back to date. So model forecast period, that should be 5 years, right? So I can put this in my input cell style. I can format this so that it shows year. I'm quite sure we know how to do that. So Control 1, go to my number, then come under my custom, right? Let me just select this one that has zero. Inside this type, these are more like basic Excel things. So I assume we, yes, I assume we are Excel guru. So open a quote, type my year, year here, close the quotes. So let me put a space there. And I'll click on my, okay, so it appears like this, right? The model, model period end. So we are going to use our, I think e-date should be able, okay. So before we do that, we also need our period, month in a period. So let's have that here, month in a period, which that will be 12 months. So let me put input 12, right? So I can also format it so that it shows in months. So I can also use the one I used previously. Put this in month. Click on my, okay. Then what is our model period end? Model period end. So what formula do you think we can use in Excel for us to get the model period end? Anyone? Anyone? What formula do you think we can use? We already have our start date, e-date, okay. So someone said e-date. Let's look at e-date. Let's look at our e-date. E-date, so this is our start date, comma. What is our month? Our month will be this year, multiply by what? By the month, close the bracket and press enter. Then put it in the date format, Control Shift 3. Now it's showing 2007. So I think we need to do what? We need to minus one there so that it gives us the actual end date. Yes, yes. Okay, so we have this. So any other things we want to add, we can always come here. So we can have our model version. So model version. Right, so we call this our model version 1.01. So we have this. Remember, this also an input cell star. So I create, put that here. So as you are building your model, right, add that shift. As I said, just come to any of the worksheets, press your shift space, then Control Shift plus sign to open it, to reduce it, Control minus. These are basic Excel things. Remember, it's part of the prerequisite needed for this bootcamp Excel. Yes, yes. So we are not teaching Excel. We are not teaching Excel. Sorry about that. Yes, it appears as if I'm fast. Sorry about that. You're going to share the recording with us. Now, let's create our templates, our templates, right? We've created our cover page, we've created our guide. Now, this our worksheet, our worksheet that we'll be using for the for our modules itself. First thing, I like reducing these first three columns. And the reason why is this. By the time we are done with our module, we are going to do something we call outline groupings. So some people, when they build modules, you always see multiple worksheets. In fact, you might need to be collapsing this guy here. Standard is saying that is not efficient, right? And by the time we are building our module, you see that instead you don't need that multiple worksheets. And that's one of the reasons why we usually collapse these first three columns so that you can have heading one, heading two, and heading three. So now let's create our sample that we'll be using for our module. So here, let me type my company. We're going to have our company name. Then we're going to have our worksheet title here. Right, so down here, let's call this. So let me increase my column D a little bit. So under my row, let's say row six, let me put my description here. Description. Then here we're going to have our input. Okay, no, here we're going to have our unit. Then here we're going to have our input. Then most times when I build my model, I like having row totals. So we have our row total here. Okay, let's row average comes first, row average. So let me short that. Let me abbreviate it. So for example, something like this row total, I can come to my guide and come here and type the same way I type it there, row average, and type it in full. So row average, right? Just creating that guide. When you are building your model, always set your mind that you build it, someone can pick the model and understand almost everything that you have done. So up here, let me call this, let's have our period start. Our period end, this will be our period end as well. Okay. So for the period start, let me reduce this column I a little bit just to create a space. Then let me start with my period end equal to. So before I do that, I can come to my worksheet here and use what we call name manager. Name manager. So every cell in Excel has an address. For example, I'm clicking on one cell like this. If you look through your name box, you can see that currently now, this is cell I12. If I click on another cell, this is K15. So which means every cell in Excel, they have their own what address. So here, this is a company name, Bootcamp Limited. And you can see currently now it's called F15. I can click on this F15 and name this my what company name. So COY, let me just call it COY. Company, enter. My FinTech, F16, I'll click on it and let me just call it industry. So which means if I go anywhere, I go in this, my Excel workbook, and I type equal to COY and I press enter, it will automatically bring what we've typed inside here automatically for us. So location, can change this to location as well. Naira is our currency. I can just type this as currency as well. Model start dates. I can just put start_dates and press my enter. This is a month in the period. Let me also name that to month. Enter. So we can make use of it. So let me delete this. So I'll come in here. My period end date will now be equal to my start date. My start date minus one. Enter. Then I'll format it Ctrl+Shift+3 to a date. So whenever you are building your model, always remember your model must have what we call base period. Even if you are building for a corporate organization or a startup, the base period is the same thing as your year zero. Then the start date will be equal to this period end date plus one. Enter, and I'll put that in my number format. Then to have our end of the month, end of the year, equal to, you can use E dates, you can also use EO month. But I think let's work with E dates. Our start date, let's put our start date as the last date. Should we use last date or the, okay, let's use this start date, comma, then our month, since we want a 12-month calendar. Close my bracket and press enter. Let me format that. So we have this. This correct. Then I put minus one so that it gives us from January to December. So we just need 5 years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All I need to do is drag it to the right. And we have this. So let me extract the year. Year. I'll just use my year formula to extract the year from it as well. Drag to the right and press my Control R. So one other thing you can do is to add F. So let's format it so that it add F is showing at the back of it. So more like a forecast. So it's, we have it like this. Right? Our company name, all I need to do is let me just link that to my equal to company. And we'll see the name of our company. Worksheet name, let me just, for at least for now, let me call it sample. Let me call it sample. So to now make this look good, I can, let me highlight from this our cell B for the years, right? And I can go ahead and just fill it with a color. So most times I really don't like that color, but at times you can still work with a color that is still fine. So I think this light color is good, right? So company name, let me increase the font, put it in the color, this blue. Let me look for a better blue that we can use. Okay, this is fine. Then our worksheet name, let me put that in red as well. So we have this. Then down here, I can put a border. Let me apply a border. Let me look for a thick border that I can put here as well. So we have this. So as I said, you can be creative with your own, right? Just make sure it's following the standard. So you can be creative. So which means I've created this. And up here, let's have our, okay. So here, let's have our life scenario. Right? So we are just creating a sample that you are going to replicate for others. So life scenario, then we are going to, let's have our balance, our model balance check here. Model balance check. We are going to have that here as well. So we have this. Then let me freeze the panel. Let me freeze the panel so you can go to your view, right? Freeze the panel and just click on the freeze the panel. So whenever they are scrolling up, scrolling down, we always have this, our headings constant. Now that we have this, now we now need to duplicate this. I'll go to my cover page. First thing I need is my assumptions, right? So to duplicate this worksheet, come to this, the name of the worksheet, hold my control and my left mouse. Automatically, one small icon will show, like more like a paper, more like a rectangle, right? Then it has one cross sign, and I will just move it just out anywhere, and it automatically duplicates itself. You can also right click and put, I think there's a duplicate one. I don't usually use that style too. So sample. So here I'm going to call this my input. This is our input cell style. Do the same thing, control left mouse, just drag it up, and I'll call this my monthly MCAC. Enter. So let me change this back to, so this guy will now be what? Input. Let me change the name, input and assumptions. Then this will be our monthly calculations, right? So let me duplicate this guy again. So this will be our monthly underscore model as well. Let me duplicate it again. Let me call this our profit or loss account. Duplicate this again. Call this balance sheet. Duplicate it. Call this cash flow. Duplicate it. And we'll call this our analysis, and then we duplicate it once again and call it my what? Let's call it DCF, or let's just put valuation as well. So what standard is saying is, whenever you are building your model must have the same structure. Yes. So if you take a look at this, you see that all the models, they are following the same structure. And that's what standard is saying. Not that this worksheet, we have different structure. This worksheet, we have another structure. This worksheet, we have another structure. I don't know if you're having a question. What about those ones that are monthly? Yes, we are still going to do that. So let me change the name. Let me change the name of the worksheet first. So this will be our monthly module. So this will be our profit or loss account. Then this will be our balance sheet. This will be our cash flow. This will be our cash flow statement. And this will be our analysis. Analysis, ratios, and metrics. We have our metrics here. Then here, let's call this our valuation. Valuation. So for this sample one, let me just call it our summary. That will be our summary worksheet. Then I can move it. Okay, I think it's fine like that. So now let's adjust this one that are monthly calculations. Here, monthly calculations. Very simple, right? To do that, all I need to do here is, you remember I put a month, let me delete everything. Now I can do that again. So for the ones that are monthly calculations, right? Now I can work smart because monthly calculation and my monthly module, both of them, we have the same structure. So I can also delete this guy. Now I can select both worksheets at the same time. And anything I'm doing here will also apply to the second worksheet. So I will hold my control and select the second worksheet, which is my M module. So which means on my M calculations, you can see that both of them are selected. Anything I am doing here will automatically apply on the other worksheet. So equal to previous year ending balance plus one, previous year ending date. Then for my period end date equal to E date, the start date, comma, then this time we just put one. The other time was 12 months. Then I will now minus one here so that we have January, we're going to have February for the respective years. Then here, let me extract the year using my year function. Extract the year here. Now we need like how many? We need like 60. So let me come here so that this guy can help us. We need a period count here. And what period count, what is going to do for us to help us count. So we are building a 12 months. We are building a 5 years model. So more like 5 multiplied by 12, that should give us 60. So I'll come here, type equal to last year plus one. So I'll just use this period count. So I can just drag it to the right. So as you are dragging it, you can also see the count here. So I think we need 60. We need this to be 60. Yes, so we need 60, we need 60. All right, so now that I have that, which means I can come here now, highlight everything here, then drag it to the right, up to where I have that 60 and press my Control R. And automatically, it's supposed to what? Supposed to have the date starting from January 1, 2022 to 31st December, right? So now, as I said, as I've done it here, if you go to my model, my monthly model, you see that we also have the same thing here. You see that I also have the same date here, right? Remember, I only highlighted both of them together. So which means I need to get out to ungroup them. I'll just click any cell, any worksheets outside them. Then we have this. So as I said, remember this, we're going to have some few of project finance. And in project finance, this is what you do. You build everything out month on month. So it's from that month, you can now convert it to your quarterly or annual or anyhow you want to convert it. But we are going to build everything out monthly. So one thing I see that most people usually do, this is what they will do. They will first create the first 12 months, right? Then you see that they will create one space here. You now start the second one here. By the time you start your calculation, you are wasting a lot of time. Our model is saying left to right consistency. Anything you put in year one, just drag it to the right and press your Control R. Your formula must be consistent. And by the time we start the build, you will see how that comes into play. So we've created our model guide. So cover page, Moodle guide. So in case you don't know much about some of these basic Excel things that we've done today, please, I will encourage us. Let's take our time. Yes, something about Excel is you cannot know it all, right? In fact, most people don't know basic Excel. So let's take our time to get better at our Excel to make us work faster, because we'll be doing a lot of magic with Excel by the time we start our training. So we have our summary worksheet layout. We have our inputs. We have our calculations worksheets layout as well. We have our monthly model. So this is where we are going to have our monthly financial statements. Then from there, we now convert it to yearly, right? On which we are going to now analyze the model. So you can see we have our valuation. So with this now, we are good to go. So the next thing is now for us to start with our input. And that is what we are going to start with by the time we start our bootcamp. I trust you've been able to gain one or two things from what we've done today. As I said, I'm going to share the video with us. Yes, you have access to the video. Use it to build your own. Now, okay, one other thing. So remember, we are not yet done. Let's create hyperlink. Hyperlink. But before we do that, most time I usually like to work with colors when I'm building my model. So let's say anything that are related to my cover page, I will right click. You see what we call tab color. So let's just put this as a blue. My guide, which is very important, let me put that as what color? Let me look for one color that we can give to it. So my summary, right click, tab color. Let me just use that with red. Inputs, right click, tab color. Let me put this guy in blue. My monthly calculations, anything calculations, let me put that in this orange. Just for you to just, you just making your model to look good. My monthly model, which is also, so let me put that in light green. Our three financial statements, let me put that in this, let me put it in a slight deep blue green. Then for the analysis, tap color, let me just put that in, let me put that in something like this. Yellow valuation standing on its own and put that in ash color. So we have this. So we have this looking good. So assumptions, I can just let me highlight and click. So to do that, so what is the standard font for models? Is there something, anything like real size? It's still this basic, it's still the normal Excel font, right? But most times I usually use 11. Generally, yeah. So as I said, my own Excel, I've set it to be bigger than the normal one. Yes, it's because of when we are doing presentation, I want you to be able to see what we are showing very well. So we usually do that. So if you look at my own formula bar, you can see my formula is very way bigger than your own if you look at it closely. Yes, so you do that just for training and screen sharing purposes. Okay, so assumption, I like working with shortcuts. Assumption, just press my Control K. So on my Control K, see place in this, you have existing file, we need place in this document. I'll just click on it, scroll up to click where I want. So this is assumption. I will click on my input and click on my OK. So if I click on this guy, look at what happened. It takes me straight to my input worksheet, right? Go back. So monthly calculations, Control K, let me put it in my what? Let me also put that in my monthly calculation. Click OK. I'm quite sure we all know how to create hyperlink. All right. So scenario, just OK. So we forgot to create scenario worksheet. So let me duplicate this, our input. Let me put it here and let me call it scenario worksheet, which is always more like the last thing we'll be doing by the time we are done with the model build. So here, let me insert. So scenario, Control K. I want it. Where is the scenario? Just click on scenario. Click on OK. My monthly model, Control K. Click on my profit or loss account. OK. Profit or loss account, annual one. So click on my place in this document. Remember, then select the worksheet. This is profit or loss account. OK. My balance sheet, Control K. I select my balance sheet to worksheet, my cash flow statements, so that just everything is being linked to their respective worksheets, and it's easy for them to navigate from here. So this is for my analysis. okay, and this is for my evaluation. And click on my, okay. So I don't like the way everything is being underlined, so I can just remove the, I can just remove that, and we have it this way, or remove the underlined. So from here, you can go to any worksheet. Now, the next thing is, from all this worksheet, we should be able to go back to this, our table of contents, right? So which means I can create something here. So let me type, let me call it table. Okay, we can just call this a table of contents, but would that be too much? So let me call it table of contents. So I can create that one here. So let me even reduce it so that can be very, very small. But most times I usually use menu. I usually use menu here, right? So let me centralize it. Then I'll create an hyperlink for this, right? Control K. So, and I'll select this, my cover page. Now, one thing I want, by the time they click on this menu from here, it should be able to come, it should be able to take them straight to this table of contents, right? So I'll look at the table of contents. This is what? This is B12. That is B12, right? So where did I create that? So B12, I can use my Control K. So under this cell, type the cell reference. I'll just type the B12 here. Then I will select the cover page. So yes, you can, you prefer cover, you prefer table of contents. Yes, that's fine. But most I usually prefer table of contents so that they understand that, oh, this is to take them back to. Now, if you look at this, let me zoom out a little bit. If I click on this menu, now it's actually showing me the location of where this file is on my desktop. That I really don't like that, right? So I can just press my Control K. And by the time I select this cover, you can see that we have something called screen tip here. So I'll click on this screen tip and just type click and just type navigate to the table of content and click on OK and OK. So whenever someone click on this, it will show them navigate to the table of content. Okay, I didn't spell my table of content very well. Let me respell that. So screen tip, navigate to my table of content, click on my OK. Then we have this. So if you click here, take them directly to this worksheet. Oh, we did not create hyperlink for summary. So when you are doing your own, make sure you remember to create that. So I can just copy this guy, copy, come to my input, paste it, come to my scenario, paste it, come to my monthly calculation, paste it somewhere around, right? So that from each worksheet, it is easy for them to navigate to the table of content as well. So we have that here, right? So this is everything we have here. So standard is saying, instead of you having multiple worksheets, so you see some, you have fixed assets calculation, working capital calculation, revenue calculation on different worksheets. Standard is saying, no, you should not do it that way. So by the time we are building it, I will show you the better way, right? And that will also, that it will not make your Excel too heavy, right? So, which means we've been able to create our Moodle template. And the next thing is for us to kickstart our Moodle build, which will be coming in our next bootcamp session. Now, back to where we started from. As our next step is this. I'm going to share the recording of this session with everyone that's present today, right? Yes, I know some people tried to join, but I think the capacity of our subscription was 100. Right, so some people were unable to join us. So I will share the video with us. Watch the recorded video. Use it to build your own template. Build your own template. Now, submit your own template before Sunday. That will be strict with time. I'm going to send it as email to everyone. Yes. I'm going to send it as email to everyone present here. Submit your own templates before Sunday. So now, please, in case you did not register on our Zoom for this session, right? Maybe you just click on the link and you join directly. You might need to send me a direct message with your email so that I can include your email information by the time I'm sending the recorded one, right? Submit your own template before Sunday, and your submission will qualify you to be chosen for the boot camp. This session was made open to everyone. We are not charging anything. We are going to take us free. And we need our commitment. That is what you are paying. Is that your commitment? Right? It is your commitment that we need. So watch this, build your model template. The training is more like hands-on and a real business case study. So we run us through it. You go ahead, you build your own. That's the best way to learn. No, I'm not going to share this Excel template with us. No. Watch the recorded video. Use it to build your own template. You can be creative. Submit your own template before Sunday. Your submission will qualify you to be chosen for the boot camp. Right? This one, this first session is made open, and the dates to the actual bootcamp will now be communicated to people that submit, right? And for the preparation, the slots we have available is around 30 or 40. So we just try to select people that we know that are very, very committed, right? So yeah, by the time you are done, just send it to me on my WhatsApp. I'm going to the same email that I will use in sending the recorded video to us is the same link you are going to use, that same email. You just submit your own Excel file. What if more than 50 people submit before Sunday? Let's see how that will be. Yes, yes, yes. So I'm quite sure before immediately we are done with the meeting, as long as immediately the video is done processing, I'm going to share that with every one of us so that you can watch the video, right? Use it to build your home. Yes, then by the time the real boot camp has not started, this one is just like introduction and to select people that will be committed. Yes, we need your commitment, right? This is more like our own community service to share our knowledge with people as well. And this is more like the second version. The first version that we did, it was very, very great. Trust me on that. Yes, yes. Okay. All right, so thank you, everyone. So in case you have any question or clarification before we round up the session, we appreciate that. So you can unmute your mic in case you have questions or you need clarification before we close the session.
Hi, Victor.
Hello. Okay, yes.
Hi, Victor. Yes, how are you? Thank you so much. This is really great. I just wanted to inquire, assuming one move on to the next stage, what is the estimated time for the bootcamp? This is something that you've done in the past, so I just wanted to inquire how long would the bootcamp last from a previous experience?
Okay, so the previous bootcamp was a full modeling thing, but this one is only the focus is on our startup, so it will likely be a 4 days session. So maybe 2 to 3 hours per each session. So it will be more like a 4 days. So the fourth day will be more of a evaluation where my colleague will be coming in to run us through the evaluation. But for this model build and the whole thing, I'll likely be 3 or 4 days. Yes, it depends on how fast we are able to get it done as well and some things that we cover. So it's likely just a 3 days bootcamp. So everything will be virtual as well. Everything will be virtual. Everything will be virtual. So we can click on our hand too so that we don't have everyone mics open at the same time. So it's just be more like a 3 or 4 days boot camps, just a very practical one. Okay, yes, Fumilayo. Okay, Fumilayo, we cannot hear you. Okay, Roland. Okay, yes.
Yeah. Hello, good evening.
Yeah, good evening.
Yeah, thank you so much for what you have done. It's really inciting. It's really explicit. But I just want to find out, too, are we going to get the video of this so that we can perfect it over the time? Over time.
Yes, that's what I'm.
Secondly, the second one, what will be the structure? How is it going to work? I know you are trying to explain it when I just quickly go back for my meeting now.
Okay, so what we've done today, the video will be shared with us, just like you can see on my screen. All right, maybe you came in a little bit late.
Okay, I can see it.
You watch this recorded video. I'm going to share that with us if you are done with the meeting. Use it to
build
your own template, submit it, then your submission will now is what will qualify you to be chosen for the main bootcamp. And that's where the information on how we are going to run the bootcamp will be shared with people that are being chosen for the bootcamp.
All right, thank you so much.
Yes, but trust me, everything will definitely be virtual, all right? And it will be more like a 3 to 4 days boot camp. So we definitely need to work with your availability so that people don't get to miss out. Yes, so those are the things we are going to consider. Yes. Okay,
thank you so much.
All right, thank you, sir. So Fumila is asking, so I just want to find out about the time for the bootcamp because of work is going to be. Oh, yes, so we understand. I'm also working as well. I'm also working. So definitely by the time we are scheduling it, maybe it might be a weekend or evening of a thing. But that will also be agreed on by people that will be chosen for the bootcamp so we can agree on what time works best for us before we have that. Okay, yes, Olubinga, are you coming?
Hello, thank you, Victor. Can you hear me, please?
Yeah, I can hear you clearly.
Thank you so much for what you've shared with us. Really appreciate it. It's a real great one. I just want to add, in addition to what others have asked before, if you want eventually qualify for the bootcamp, then will you give opportunity for some of us to maybe share existing templates or models that you have to work with you to modify it so that it aligns to the fast requirement?
Sorry, I didn't get that.
Thank you.
Can you rephrase that, sir?
Okay, can you hear me now?
Can I hear you? Yes, I just wanted to rephrase it very well.
Okay. So I said, if one eventually qualifies for the bootcamp,
yes,
would you give an opportunity for some of us that have maybe some existing models, such that you could work with us to align such models to the FAST requirement, the FAST, you know, flexible and things like that requirement? Would there be such opportunity?
I believe there will be, because we're also trying to create a financial model community, right, where we can always instead of this coming once in a while, we can have a recurring one, and we can always have a session where we get to rub minds, get to look, you have a case study modeling, you bring it, we all look at it, and we get to share minds. So definitely we're going to have that.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right, sir. Okay, Tinilolua. Yes, your hand is up. Remember to unmute your mic, Tinilolua.
Good evening. Thank you so much, Victor. So my question is, the boot camp, like, are we getting any certificates, or we just do it and we're just for the fun, or we're just going to join the community, or is there any other, what are the other pros for the bootcamp that are going to benefit?
Number one, I can hear you clearly. Number one thing about me is, I don't know, I'm really not a certificate person per se. I believe in, I know this thing, come rain, come shine. Yes, I know it. Even if someone has a certificate of certificates, right? You bring the person close to me. Let's rub it together. As I said, the bootcamp is 100% free. It's for you to get better, and also I was able to have a good career and upper hand because I know financial modeling. So based on that, if it's a skill that you have, right, that can help you get better or to your next stage in your career, I feel it is way, way better than ordinary certificates inside a paper that someone cannot defend. That being set aside, if you want a certificate, as I said, this is 100% free, right? 100% free. We did not collect money from anybody. But if you think, okay, after the bootcamp, you want a certificate, right? Then maybe after the bootcamp, we can now discuss that, how we can get you a recognized certificate on this. All right, so it's not about just writing a paper that is a certificate, but a recognized certificate. So maybe we try and talk to Financial Modeling Institute. They can give us their stamp and all those things, but that will be discussed after the bootcamp. Yes. Okay, so someone is asking, do you have to use any company to build the templates or in general? So just try to replicate what we did today. Yes, remember, we are building a startup. We are building for a startup. So we are still going to run through the actual business case study that we want to use. So this one is replicate what we've done today. Exactly. Okay, all right. Okay, Lillian.
Hi, Victor. Good evening.
Yes. How are you doing?
Yes, I'm fine. Thank you. I want to say thank you for this session. It's really been very enlightening. Please, I just want to make, I don't know, is it a suggestion or a request? For those of us that will be successful for the main bootcamp, I just want to please thank you, maybe expand it a bit.
I don't know, your headset, maybe you need to adjust your headset. It's making noise, so I can hardly hear you. I think the noise is much. Okay, I think it's better now.
Okay. So I
think maybe you should try and type it out. Yes, maybe you're on the road. That's why the noise is everything. Yes. Okay, so thank you for that, Maiwa. So just to add to the certificate question, right? Certificates, yes, it does not matter, but it matters as well. The truth about it is no one is going to believe you are a skilled financial modeler from certificate only. And that's the truth. Even if you're applying for any job today, they will still give you a real business case study, irrespective of your certificate. As I said, maybe by the time we are done with this bootcamp, maybe you have interest in being certified as a financial modeler. Then you can go for the Financial Modeling Institute certification. Yes, so they are more like independent body, the same way we have for ICANN, we have ACCA, we have our CFA. Yes, the same way we have for our Financial Modeling Institute. So if you prefer that, I think that would be a better option for you. Yes, thank you, Maiwa, for that as well. So someone is asking, do you offer one-on-one modeling classes? Yes, I do. So you can reach out to find out more about that. So, okay, please, just a suggestion that you expand the scope beyond startup, maybe building. This is more like the first boot. This is like the second bootcamp. The first bootcamp that we had last year, in fact, we covered almost both for startup and corporate modeling. Yes, we cover the model concept as a whole. So let's look at let's look at how things will go. So maybe we can have that kind of bootcamp again, where we cover both for startup, corporate model, and the modeling as a whole. Yeah, so let's see how that will be. But for this one, the focus is more on startup and for people that have at least prior knowledge. Yes, thank you for that. All right, so do you still have any other question before we call it a day? Do we get a mentorship opportunity with you after the session? Okay, yes, we are working on that as well. Yes, that mentorship of a team. Yes, so where we have a community of modelers, because you need the question and some things, we can always discuss that. Okay, So as I said, we'll definitely be sharing that with us. We're going to share this. If you registered for the Zoom meeting, definitely I have your email. But in case you did not register for the bootcamp and you are here already, right? So let me share my email with us so that you can forward your email and I can add you to the list of people I'll be sending this to. Yes, I know many people wanted to join this, but because the space is limited to 100. Yes, so you can share your email with me so that I can add you to the list and I can forward the recordings to us as well.